Depraved liberal predators have been coming out of the woodwork in droves within the last 30 days, as women claiming to be victims of various forms of sexual misconduct keep surfacing daily. The one thing that the attackers have in common is that they all seem to be liberal, many of whom have railed on President Donald Trump for something he said almost a decade ago, not did. Karma is coming back to haunt them, and it continues to get worse each day. Now, it has just reached a low point with the leader of the Dirty Democrat PAC being former President Barack Obama himself. Trump's successor will soon be finding himself in a world of hurt if everything in this video is as bad as it looks. This could be the final straw that ends the Obama's marriage, which seemed to already be teetering on the edge of failure. A video of Barack Obama allegedly engaging in some grossly inappropriate sexual misconduct just surfaced at a non-coincidental time. CNN has reportedly had the footage in their possession for quite some time and finally released it after he was out of the White House, when it could do no damage to him. We've seen that these Democrats can legitimately get away with murder if Hillary Clinton's body count tells us anything. Now, the leader of the party that pushes women's rights will likely get away with abusing his power and disrespecting a woman under uncomfortable circumstances. After the now infamous grab-am comment Donald Trump made on a hot mic before he was president, Barack publicly called his successor repugnant. It now seems like he was deflecting in those remarks, because what Trump said pales in comparison to Barack's dirty secret and this grotesque footage, which he hasn't, and probably won't, apologize for. On this flip side, Trump did actually ask for forgiveness and admitted that he has never been perfect. This was an honorable response, and while the left continues to punish him for his 2011 remarks, they are strangely silent about Barack and his dancing erection. Listen to comments. OMG. Turns out, this video has existed since 2008, and CNN has been hiding it, 3% her nation claims. Think about this, NBC had the infamous Trump tapes and could have released them during the primary elections against Ted Cruz. Instead, they waited until Trump was running against Democrat Hillary Clinton. CNN has done something even more despicable. They hid the video altogether to protect Obama, who, obviously, has survived two election cycles. If it's true that CNN intentionally concealed this footage from three presidential elections ago, then the network is even more depraved than we already knew. What makes it worse is all the attention they gave Trump's locker room remarks to a reporter while knowingly keeping this disturbing video of Barack a secret. PJ Media uncovered more of this apparent cover-up. The site reports, underscore back in 2008, at least a portion of the below video of Obama flaunting himself did appear on CNN's website. Underscore, however, no media coverage made any reference to lewdness. There was just underscore reference underscore to the unremarkable news that Obama was wearing jeans. Underscore, CNN captioned the clip with only what follows, which Michelle Melkin and Dela Pundit took note of at the time. Underscore, it appears that the portion of the video that would have created a firestorm had been circumcised by CNN editors. Underscore, this link to the video, as it appeared on CNN's site at the time, was included in Ola Pundit's post, www.cnn.com where blink, underscore that link is no longer active. Neither is this one, which purportedly linked to the CNN video that had been uploaded to YouTube, www.youtube.com where blink. It's clear that the Democrat Party is dirty in a number of ways, and there's no hiding from all the sexual misconduct issues and truly disturbing sex crimes they have been keeping under wraps for years. Proving this is a list of 24 liberal sex scandals that mainstream media is refusing to report, as compiled by the Daily Wire. 1. Four new women accuse Bill Clinton of sexual assault. November 20, 2017. Former President Bill Clinton was accused of multiple incidents by four women. We already know about his lust for using an intern to hold his cigar and how he may have ruined her dress with some bodily fluids. What's up with the other accusations? Daily Mail ran this story. 2. Congresswoman accuses Democrat former Congressman Bob Filner of sexually assaulting her. November 21, 2017, according to the Huffington Post, Rep. Diana DeGette, D. Colorado, accused former Congressman Bob Filner of trying to pin her in an elevator and forcibly kiss her. The Huffington Post ran this. Shocking. They're about as leftist as one could get, and it's a breath of fresh air to see that they would run a story against a Democrat. I still think the HuffPost horrible site filled with virtue signalers, Black Lives Matter enthusiasts, and gender study liberals and feminists, but that's just my opinion. 3. California Democrat Raul Bocanegra resigns leadership position and won't seek re-election over sexual allegations. November 20, 2017, the Los Angeles Times reported that California Democratic Assemblyman Raul Bocanegra said he would suspend his campaign and not seek re-election in the face that a story would be dropping about six women accusing him of sexual harassment. Not seeking re-election smells like guilt to me. 4. Democrat congressional candidate from New Mexico David Alcon was arrested for stalking in New Mexico. November 13, 2017, according to the Washington Free Beacon, Alcon was arrested after sending a woman persistent messages, including of his genitals, telling her he loved her and suggesting he was watching her. Hasn't anyone learned from Anthony Weiner that we don't send private pics anymore? When you're a politician, the last thing you do is send some chick a picture of your penis and corny messages like you're some desperate chump who can't get a woman. If a woman wants to see it, then she needs to see it in person. Sending pictures of your privates will only bite you on the rear end later. Take it from the king of private pics, Mr. Anthony Weiner himself. Don't do it. But did CNN run the story and show the pics? Doubt it. 5. 10 women accuse Colorado Democratic lawmaker Steve Lebsack of sexual harassment. November 10, 2017, CBS Denver reports that the 10 women include the legislative aide who harassed her at a bar. 10 women is a lot. Are the accusations true? Did CNN run the story and ask every accuser and do the stories match up? One woman is a lot, but when 10 say it, then you have to wonder. 6. Colorado Democratic House Speaker Chrysinta Duran accused of covering up sexual allegations against Democrat Steve Lebsack. November 14, 2017, according to the Denver Post, Colorado's top Democratic lawmaker is under fire for how she handled a colleague's sexual harassment complaint against a member of their party and now faces calls for an independent investigation. I bet women are thrilled to hear about a woman hiding sexual allegations. Was she in on it? What was her reward for covering up the possible crimes? What did CNN have to say about it? 7. Minnesota Democratic lawmaker Dan Schoen resigns over sexual harassment allegations. November 21, 2017, the Min Post reported that two women accused Schoen of sexually harassing them. One was a former DFL candidate for House who alleged that he grabbed her buttocks, telling her she had a good door knocking ass. What exactly is a door-knocking ass? I have not ever heard of that before. I know a good one when I see it, and that's not something I've ever referred to one as. Men can't say they don't look, because we do. Everyone looks. However, looking and committing sexual harassment is a huge difference. Everyone looks at each other in one way or another, but that does not warrant any type of grabbing. You can look at the merchandise, but you can't touch it. 8. A third woman accuses California Democrat Senator Tony Mendoza of sexual harassment. November 16, 2017, according to the Sacramento Bee, a woman said that California State Senator Tony Mendoza behaved inappropriately toward her when she worked in his Capitol office 7 years as a legislative aide in Sacramento. I wonder what his inappropriate behavior consists of. Was it comments? Grabbing? Sexually charged text messages? What was it, Tony? 9. Sexual harassment controversy threatens to ensnare California Democratic Senate leader Kevin DeLeon. November 11, 2017, the Mercury News reported that there are questions about whether Kevin DeLeon may have helped to try to cover up complaints against Senator Tony Mendoza. If Tony's act requires a cover-up, then it probably wasn't a very nice gesture or behavior towards women. 10. Democrat Under Commissioners President Philip are charged with multiple counts of child pornography. October 11, 2017, according to the Inquirer, Philip Parr was arrested on numerous felony counts. Authorities said Darr sent and received hundreds of images of child sexual abuse, some involving infants and toddlers, others depicting sadomasochistic abuse and abuse involving children and animals. "I'm going to vomit. This is disgusting. There is enough rated adult content on the internet that one does not ever have to look at something like this. This is horrible. I searched CNN for Philip Parr and their website provided no results. CNN did not cover this incident at all. Not even a mention of the man and his disgusting crime. I took a screenshot to prove it."